Honey knows that. Oh, you saw the picture over there.
All right.
What was Julia? Oh, here's a. This one. Now this was a. This is a. Only I thought I might be the only one knows this. Except maybe mom and maybe.
So don't share that here.
What was Julia's nickname on her school? Well, wait a minute. I should do this. I should scrub. What sports did Julia participate in through high school?
Hockey.
What kind of hockey?
Field hockey.
Yeah. What else? Not bad.
Gymnastics.
Any of you that have seen her tumble, she still has a crooked neck, so she doesn't try that anymore, but she used to be quite a gymnast, doing the after-school thing. And that's why her back is in such bad shape, because she could do the walkovers and the bars and all that kind of thing. Okay, what was Julia's nickname on her high school field hockey team?
Killer.
That's close, huh?
Red.
Buck? No, Buck. Not Red, not Big Red.
Buck.
Buck's good.
Okay, let's take a vote.
Okay, her name was Stid, of course. So they kind of did a derivative.
Yes. You want us to say something?
Super Scoop, right? Oh, Super Scoop. Or Super Stid, I don't know what they call it.
Yeah.
Okay, this one I'm not sure of. So, you can help me out. What was the name of the rock band she and Greg sang in with Bonnie Barbarian? What was the name of
it? How long is that band?
Some of you saw it. What was the name of the band?
I'm screaming.
Well, I don't remember. What was it called?
Yeah, no
kidding.
Every time we had a game, we had to change our
mind. Oh. What was Julia and her roommate friend Teresa backed out of what activity at the last minute when she was at BYU? At the very last minute. What activity did they back out of just before they could?
Skydiving.
They went through the whole training. They're going to jump out of the plane and not going to do it.
Good brains.
Okay. Here goes a multiple choice. Where was Julia born? In the back of a Mercedes. Idaho Falls, Idaho. Salt Lake City, Utah. Southern California. Venus.
Venus.
You can't move that chair there, Andy. That's back some of those pictures.
Number two.
Two was Idaho Falls. Southern Cal.
Northridge.
Shook
it all up.
No kidding.
Okay. Name the city where Julia has not performed. Carnegie Hall, New York City. Hollywood Bowl, Los Angeles. Music Verein, Vienna. Moscow Symphony Hall. Santa Clara Mission, Santa Clara.
Hollywood Bowl.
All right. What major milestone did she just cross? A. Her first hot flash. B. Weighs less than when she was in high school. C. Married longer than single. Where's the rest of them? All right, what was it?
We're on C.
C.
I say all of the above.
I don't know about the others. All right, that. Okay.
What's the answer?
And the answer is?
Oh. Well, that's the intro of where I'm going. That's enough. Does anybody know the name of her arts and crafts business?
Hatchery.
Hey, Rick, I'll promise you when she starts hot flashes, you'll know.
I'm looking forward to that one. Joy and I have she's just crossed that milestone where she's been married longer than she was single. I still have yet to come to that point. quite a few years. So that's quite a milestone. She can remember when her mom and dad crossed that point, where her dad used to go around saying, I've been married longer than I've been single. So it's something to contemplate on, and something now you two will remember. But this is our 2040 year.
Yeah.
or 24, married 20 years, and she turns 40. So it was quite an event, so we tried to throw a few things. That's why I want to make this special, because you're not going to see this again, dear. I doubt for many, many years. So tonight, I'm wondering, let's have a vote. Where should Julia be during all this, since all of you know what's going on? Should we sit her right up here? Okay, give me a chair. Julia, come on up. Come on, sweets. I'll get things rolling because it's probably, I'm not sure, it's either downhill or uphill, either one direction. I'm not sure, it depends on how this goes on. But we are sharing our special memories here tonight for you here. And
it's a roast, Julia.
Oh, is that, yeah, I was going to use the word. But.
It's a grill.
We are you going to talk about?
No. I'm not saying, there might be some people that are nice, so you can applaud that.
Is my friend going to be nice? Ooh, the things they can tell on me tonight.
Well, one of those things that I want to tell on her tonight, you know, she's a woman of incredible talents. And I didn't know that when I first went to school, and I had this list of things that I was looking for in a mate. It was a long list, you know, and I saw her roommates first, and they were, you know, gorgeous. And,
they're blonde and buxom.
Yeah,
oh,
no,
you're not allowed to speak. Killer. You think it's first about her dear eyes?
Needless to say. Needless to say, she rose to the top of the list, and it was amazing in my eyes to just see everything being checked off on my list. It was just amazing. So that went pretty quickly. And so I started learning about all these talents that she had. And there's one talent I want to share with you tonight that most of you do not know about. Now, you know that she has artistic taste. I've been thinking about how I was going to do this. You see around here all these wonderful pictures of Julia. I would say that maybe, let me set up the situation. Again, she's a woman of many talents, and you know that she loves to record the lives of her children, which you'll find out more about. And you know, your kids do funny little things all the time. You grab the camera.
Oh no, you did.
And Becca had painted herself blue, and it was so she thought it was so cute.
It comes up.
Another milestone coming.
So she grabbed Becca. She was sitting in a very peculiar place. So Becca was sitting in a very peculiar place. It was in the bathroom on the sink. Okay? And so she was all painted blue and she had her binky on. And so Julia, of course, wanted to record the moment for all posterity. So she grabs the camera and backs out, okay, small. And takes a beautiful picture. Well, that's only half the story. The thing is, she just come out of the shower. And what's in the bathroom? So let's see. If I advance every projector to the next position. Let's say that I will keep that one forever in my private collection.
Greg, you understand that's what it was originally for.
No.
You know, not often do you get those kind of pictures of yourself, especially a self-portrait. But the thing I think why the guy in the photo lab let it go is because when the flash went off, you can't see your face. So you don't know who this woman is. So anyway, that starts thing off. Again, I don't know whether it's uphill or downhill. But we have some special remembrances to go by tonight. And so I'm not everyone has to share. So maybe a couple decided between themselves who would be their spokespeople. Or if you both have something, that's great. So and I didn't number things. So I'm going to, how am I going to do this? Alicia, can you go first? Get us right started into things.
We'll never think of you quite the same.
Does that mean I have to go up front?
Yes, you have to come up front. I have to have you on camera. We have to watch her face.
Brand.
Push it here and then down.
Well, my history with Julia has only been very brief in the last couple of years, but I got to know her very well. We sing in the crowd together, and I got to know her very well just when we went on tour to Europe together. Well, I was running through the list. I wasn't sure.
When I'm out of the country, I just feel.
Yeah. So I actually have one fun memory and then one funny memory. The first one, we had decided we were in, it was Prague, and it was this beautiful black night, and Prague has this beautiful river that runs through the center of the city, and there's a big, it's called the St. Charles Bridge. And we had been walking up and down the bridge, and we saw that there were boats that could take people out on the water, and Julie, we've got to do this, this is so perfect, we've got to go. So we ran up and down trying to find where this boat was, and we found it was this darling, darling boy. And of course, all through Europe, Julia was trying to get married off. So every single man, Alicia, he's perfect for you. And so she was, needless to say, trying to set me up with this young man who we found out was married. But little problem, but anyway, so he took us out, and it was a very shallow boat. And we started singing every show tune at the top of our voice. And it's not a very funny story, but it's one of my fondest memories of Julia and someone to be really crazy with and sing with. It was just wonderful. I will remember that dark night on the water. But thank you for that wonderful memory. That was really special. But the story that I want to tell is the story. We were going up, I believe it was in Salzburg, and we were driving up this very, very narrow, windy road. And Julia, of course, the whole time we were in the bus, it's a double-decker bus, packed full of people. Julia's running up and down, you know, laughing, entertaining everyone, as she usually does. And so she thought it would be really, really fun to stick her head out of the top of the bus. And so here's Julia, you all come up, it's great up here, come look, you know, so she's getting everyone to stick their heads out of the top of the bus.
The vent pool.
Right. Climbing up on the seats to do it. And everyone says, you know, there's a bridge coming up, and we didn't know how close the bridge would be. And so Julia's sticking her head out, and all of a sudden she realizes that it's coming up, and she pulls her head down. The bus stops right under the bridge, and there's about an inch between the top of the bus and the bottom of the bridge.
I would have made the news.
Take the light off your face.
Well, just can I turn? How about if I turn?
Remind me of you.
Can she stand there?
Yeah.
Okay.
You'll see why. When
just kind of remind you of two. You weren't like I thought you would have been. So inside. In other words, you would think there would be something really, like I would be giving you something nice inside this. I have, first of all, 40
friends.
Because
40 friends.
Vic. But I actually hear that Julie drinks a lot of red wine.
That's a big gulp.
Yeah, my kids tell the same thing about me, so I think I'd probably drink more diet coke than she did. But inside, I have three little. When I think of her, at school, she's going a million directions, and I hear all these things that she's got going. So I have a little juggling ball, but they're not going to. The marker's not permanent, but I've listed 40 things that you are juggling. So I started with
just don't put your finger on it. It's this finger up here.
Then I was tired. And then, like any mother, You're the last thing. You're like number 40.
So, oh, my.
Actually, I'll hang out for a minute in the back, and then I have
to scoot out. Thank you very much. Does anybody want, we can pull up this garage door.
She's got ironing, it's one of the things. Oh, yeah.
Would that be a good idea? Darlene, you get to go next. You or Clark.
I got to go from the furnace. They're too fun. Residency meeting, painting murals, corral,
quiet. Amolliver gets to go next.
Okay.
They're not ready for next
graded
yet.
Good job, Amy. That was nice.
I told you it wouldn't
hold.
Andy?
Yeah.
Emily's idea.
Woof.
At least no one was sitting here.
There's two things I like to say. First of all, when my kids were in high school and I needed something done, I run over to Julia, and in the midst of doing whatever she was doing, she'd stop and make a poster that I needed to have for high school, because the kids were running for an office or something.
They always won.
Yes,
don't
posters.
Killer posters.
That's how come they won, is Julia's posters.
It had nothing to do with they were incredibly handsome.
And she was always willing to help me, and I really came to admire the many talents, as Rick says, that she has. But one of the other things, I know she's really the life of a party. And we were at a bridal shower. Or it was a baby shower, that's right, it was a baby shower. And she was relating a story of something that I was not familiar with at the time, because when I had children, we didn't have these things. And there were monitors.
Oh!
And she was telling the story about she and Rick and this monitor that they had. And so I really couldn't understand it, because at the time, I just had not had any experience with a monitor. But now that Jolene's with me, and we've had the baby in there, and she has a monitor, I could really see the story that she was telling. Well, it seems like she had just, well, had a baby. Is that it?
I think it might have been a baby.
Yes, a baby was in there, and Rick's mother was visiting.
The baby was in our bedroom.
That's right, in your bedroom. And so they had the monitor in the bedroom, and the other part of it was in the kitchen. And his mother was in the kitchen. She was visiting, she was doing things. Well, they had decided to
turn in early then.
Early and have a little conversation. And during this conversation that they were having, the monitor, she forgot to turn off the monitor. And mom-in-law was in the kitchen, and all of everything that during your conversation happened. And so after they finished their conversation, and she walked into the kitchen, and she heard Rick making some noises up there in the bedroom, and then she went, oh. And she looked at her mother-in-law, and her mother-in-law was busy reading.
Second Nephi.
Well, that, I thought that was a great story. Look at that. Until Jolene was there with the baby, I had no clue as to how these monitors work. I'm sure they're now. I think that's the greatest story ever.
Now they have video ones. Just imagine.
Yes. Oh. Yes.
I'll let somebody else go while I'm looking for my next thing. Okay. Honey.
I think we distracted a little.
Happy
memories.
Yeah, I saw Custard.
Did that story kind of distract you?
He probably didn't hear it.
Well, let's say I was more inhibited after I knew that the monitor was on.
And then actually he said, she'll know we love each other. And he says, well, you know, maybe she could think we were up here exercising. He said that. So turn your monitors off.
Am I truly?
Oh, dear.
Dad, I just have the sharpening. It looks really blurry. It might be the light, but I can't remember which one is it.
Here, right here. Focus.
Yeah, you can actually go regular.
Okay, now it's on manual. You can focus it manual.
We have the speaker. Yeah. All right.
Yeah, I think it's just the light.
I was good in high school. I was way, way good in high school.
We were in different cliques.
We were in different cliques. At your party, I can tell stories.
Why, did you go to her party?
No.
When I turned, she thought I was already 40.
She's got a whole month.
Tonight, she says, you've already been there, haven't you? No, a couple months ago. Thank you very much. Unlike, I guess, Darlene's kids, other people's kids, Sarah did not win the secretary job. You were most.
That's true. Right from here.
Julia's come in for me too. Like, I remember buying a platter for my mother and father for their 25th anniversary, and I paid some gal at Avery's to inscribe something beautiful on the back about, you know, from your loving children, and I named us, me and my brothers. Well, my sister-in-law, I had told about this, has been out of shape and upset her, so I rushed to Julia's with this platter. Said, "Could you please do something with this platter? It just has our names on it. Could you erase it?" And so she came through like a champ. Just put from your loving children and grandchildren. Save the day. My sister-in-law talks to me now. But I have to tell you a recent story. We went to our 20-year reunion together, Julia and I. Had to kind of coax her along. I got to tell you, this woman unleashed on somebody that night. She was harassed through her senior, I guess through how many years?
Oh, 4 years.
Four years of high school. This same guy harassed Julia every day at school. And
in high school.
She found him at the reunion. And basically cornered the guy, and by the end of the evening, he was like, just hit me, please, just get over it, just hit me. Yeah. Come to find out, he lived in our neighborhood, and one of his children went to the school she was teaching at. And I think bottom line was, she said, your son could flunk art. She was ruthless that night.
I was. It felt bad, yeah.
And she also got most artistic in high school, and most children at the reunion.
Oh, gee!
Thank you.
Here's someone, I haven't heard this all the way through, so. She'll know who it is. It's an old friend that couldn't be here tonight. See, I don't know if this will come to the
phone.
Well,
this is Bill Simpson. Unfortunately, although John and I are dying to have a death, we are not going to be able to be there for probably this Friday night. I've been out of town for approximately a week.
One of my best friends, one of my roommates.
Just received the invitation. Therefore, I'm going to leave a little message. With a little vignette on this voicemail, hoping that you can record it and maybe play it that night. My memories of Julia, gee, where do I begin?
Who is it?
One time she was a little red-headed, ivy-faced freshman who we loved to play practical jokes on, such as April Fool's Day. What year would it have been? 1974, 75? I can't remember how old you are, but... But at any rate, we sneaked into the girl's apartment at Brownstone in Provo.
Uruguay.
We happened to be our family home evening sisters, and pumped up all of the speakers on their stereo, and sometime at approximately 2 or 3 in the morning, started blasting either messages or music into the apartment, waking, of course, everybody there.
From our apartment.
Scaring them to death. Beyond that, probably the best kept secret since John F. Kennedy Jr.'s marriage this last weekend was the fact that Rick was dating Julia. Amazingly, it was a surprise to all of us when A, we found out they were going together. B, it was quite curious. And C, for crying out loud, they were engaged. Rick had never been known as quite the ladies' man to keep something like that from us. But he did it, and it worked. And thankfully, Rick's been a better person for it.
Played on armpits. Through their speakers, but controlled from our apartment. That was a good trick. Okay. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Karen.
Karen, yeah.
Oh, dear.
She knows everything.
She'll have to edit some of hers because she's got so many stories.
I'll be good.
I got my ear cocked on this one because she can tell too many. I ought to be nervous.
You know what's funny? When this came up, I thought, yes, it's my chance. I get to roast her. Yes. I went through all this, you know, paper, pencil, and the memory was almost intact kind of thing.
That's a lie.
And I mean, we've gone through so much for so many years. And I thought, yes, everything I thought of, the joke was on me. Every single thing. I mean, we laughed and cried, we've done it all together, and yet every single time something happened, wherever we went, whatever we did, the joke was on me. Shut up. This is yours. And so I thought, oh my gosh, I've got to do a tribute. I wasn't even happy about it either. But if you really think about it, that's true.
It is true.
Yeah. I wrote it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, I want you to know that in itself is a talent.
Thanks. Nail your friends. Yeah, that's my specialty.
That is. And I thought, you know, I'm not very easily blown away by people or talented people. I've got some kids that are pretty talented and so forth. But there is one person I am in awe, and that is Julia. I always have been. I am literally in awe. There's nothing that she cannot do, almost. I reserve that for the very end here. But really, I mean, you know, she paints, she sings, she speaks eloquently. I always look at it, just to say a prayer, you know. Why won't my mind work like that? You know, it's in my heart. Why can't it come out like hers? And with the lessons and so forth, the creativity that's hers, the intelligence on top of all this, and even with intelligent people usually have no common sense. She's even got the common sense. So I just thought, gee, you know, there is nothing, almost, that she can't do. And then I thought about, yeah, I've got one up on her. I've got a couple of years up on her too, but I have one up on her, and I want
thanks,
you.
Thanks, Mom.
You're dead. Oh, I do know one on you. I do know one. Mixed company. But no, really, there is one thing, and I've tried to teach her over the years, and I've encouraged her, and I've mimicked it, and it's so simple. It's two letters. But Julia can't say the word no. I mean, someone this talented and this bright and this everything, she can't say no. And since we are forever friends and we will always be friends, I'm going to continue to teach her someday because I feel very protective towards her. Besides loving her to death. And I'm going to teach her how to say no at the appropriate time, because a positive no is really quite good to do. So I love her to death, and I think she's a doll, and have a good time.
Everybody's breaking my rules, Julia. Well, not everybody. So I said no gifts, but you know.
You said gag gifts.
All right. Yeah. That's
a gag gift.
I said she's a doll. It's a gag.
Jeez.
Oh.
You're welcome.
It's a fun memory.
Yes.
Resident dolly.
Yeah.
And when mine goes, I'll take this into the hairdresser and say, make it match.
Okay, I want to keep things rolling. Julia?
Just be thankful you can do that, Julia.
So what is your favorite color of hair?
What's my favorite color of hair?
Wasn't that on your sheets, Rick?
What's my favorite color
of hair?
On one of the questions.
He didn't use
my
that one.
My favorite color of hair is red. I love red hair.
What is the name of her hair color she prefers? What is the name of the hair color she prefers?
In other words, what color do you use in the bottle?
Lady.
Surely we jest. I can tell you a naughty joke about that too, but mixed company.
Speaking of naughty jokes,
about
Julia,
this is my natural.
If
color.
This was blue,
I've got a blue ribbon.
A friend of yours asked me to tie a blue ribbon around a Diet Coke can. Do you know who this is?
Don. Oh my word.
I don't know if he's going to explain that or not.
I hope not.
But he asked me what kind of crowd this is, so I have not listened to this.
He's a great Jewish attorney up in Seattle that I just adore.
They met on the cruise, all the family.
And he's really a kick of the pants.
Wednesday, 1:13, 7 p.m. Test, test,
test. Oh, not that guy. I was making sure Don could get through all right.
Who's the little machine?
It's Pat's. We don't run out of batteries.
Julia, this is a message from a Scotchman in Seattle. I couldn't make it down for your lovely birthday, but I did have your fine husband give you some corks you can slam down, because I know you're one of the greatest slammer downers there is. And I asked him, of course, to tie it with a blue ribbon. My bride and I wish you many, many happy returns of the day. It's so nice to have met you, to talk to you, and to spend the time with you. Wish we could be there to celebrate your birthday with you. But for right now, I'm sure proud you've taken first prize. Best wishes. Goodbye.
If you ever know the Scottish folk song that's on the albums of Dr. Demento, you'll know what the blue ribbon is. But I didn't. I only knew about it because it was on the song. They didn't know it was a song. They heard it
it's
as a
song?
Joke. It's a folk song. I haven't.
It's a good joke. I'll tell you later.
Okay.
Same song?
Sheila, do you want?
She doesn't do the line.
Well, I have to read mine because it's kind of a little story.
Oh, here. She used to beat me up, so I'll be very quiet.
And it's called The Day I Saw a Moon Shine Brighter Than the Sun. Are you really a redhead? It all began on a very quiet, peaceful, and beautifully sunny afternoon of a girls' camp about 4 or 5 short years ago.
Oh no.
I believe it was Patsy Wilson, Julia, and myself who were sitting together while the girls were enjoying their last days swimming at the lake. Suddenly, out of the blue, and out of her soup, came Julia. Come on, she yells. Let's all skinny dipping. I, for one, was shocked. As you could imagine, to think that anyone would disrobe and plunge into the lake without a thought to how it could emotionally scar those of us who had to witness such a scene. Patsy was pale and speechless, and she too was shocked into a coma-like trance at that sight. You need to understand that we were not alone at the lake. We're just around the corner, the young women and other leaders, including the unsuspecting priesthood leaders, who freely give up their time and efforts, were oh so close around the corner to being subjected to this blatant disregard for modesty. Thank goodness for Patsy and I, who guarded the area.
Oh,
who guarded the area
as though that no one else would have to witness this climbing, butt naked, aging, neon glowing moon shining as all big as all get out. And she showed off her freestyle in more ways than one. This was the first and last time I had ever seen a moon shining brighter than the noonday sun. And I thank Julia for that memorable moment that I have to, I mean, get to relive over the each time I sit and gaze up at the moon.
Okay, I have a test of this.
Your kids should not hear this stuff.
Well,
there's much more to
hear. You can't tell them anything now. Be good.
Oh dear. Okay, let's see if this works. I haven't tested it out yet.
Oh dear. That was like 10 years.
I do love that.
Stop.
Yeah.
Like
10 years.
No.
Can you sleep with yourself? I don't recall being alone.
I was pushing it.
This is Madeline's video by profession.
Your video's not in there.
Push play.
Hey, you should see the computer specialists. They sit up every night till 4. Did you see?
No.
And so there was somebody there taking tickets. We didn't have tickets. And so it's like, quick, get on the bus. And Julie just grabs my sister, Diane, quick, get on the bus. And we just jump on and close the doors and wave at the guys. We drive away. Oh, shit.
Just yell, Therese.
If you've ever done any traveling with Julie, you know that you have magical moments, you have insane moments.
You have terrifying moments, rip your head off.
But it's well worth your time if you have a chance to go travel. Yeah.
Two of my births, she wasn't there, but I have to say, all my children, my three last children, she was there for me when I had my babies. She was always kind enough to come to the hospital in the morning of and hold my baby, especially with Jenna. She was there for me. She came just to hold and share that moment with me that meant a lot to me. And why I showered today, but for the baptisms, every time the little two baptisms that my children have had, she has been there for me to do whatever I needed to do. She was there to sing, to make beautiful posters to set up for my girls that they will never forget and will have forever, I think, that. And the one memory that I have of Joy that I'll never, ever forget is when we had Danny, our first little boy, and I came home from the hospital, and there on my garage door was, "It's a boy," or "Welcome, Danny." I'm not even really quite sure what it was, but I remember this beautiful poster done, and this nice shower that she gave me. It was so sweet. And it was about a few weeks after the shower that Danny had a staph infection in his eye, and I was in the hospital with Danny. And I had just got there, and they had taken a blood count. And anyway, the nurses kind of scared me. So the first person I called was Julia, and all she said was, "I'm on my way, and I'll be there." And how sweet it was. She's such a good, dear friend.
Surprise guest number.
Well, hold on 1 minute.
Oh.
And this is for you. And I've been kind of roasting, toasting her all week a little bit.
Yeah,
I
she has. Every day brought me over something. Black, I knew you'd be tired, so I brought you something because you know you are.
Oh, so I thought I'd use a flower.
Ooh, that is
plant. It kind of looks a little like she's having a baby girl, so I had that.
and a baby boy
with the cards. So I had to black it up a
little. I'm still.
But because she loves to plant in her yard.
Okay. That's not my station.
Julia, does this music bring back fond memories of our first time at girls' camp? On your 40th birthday, we want you to recall some of our most famous and most wonderful memories. My first one of you is that year we were cabin counselors together up there with Karen Eve. And to Ice Castle music, you did the synchronized nose picking. Picking the green gummy worm at the end in the finale as you twirled and threw it into the audience. If I even started on the memories of girls camp, I would be here all day, and Rick only asked for a few minutes so that the whole evening isn't one person speaking. So, another memory I have is the art class out on the rock with the watercolors. And also over there, I forget where it's at, in that Cambrian shopping plaza when we went to do the art class that one morning. Good memories in art. The golden green ball, putting those stars all over the ceiling and wherever they ended up. Many lessons learned that even in the frills of, I'm going on and on and on here, that giving me the clue here. Of our clogging class that we took, many of the people in the audience or at your party probably don't realize that you and Rick are proficient cloggers. Not only do you dance and sing, play the piano, you also clog. I have landed a flat bed here in my own neighborhood. I have a diesel truck driver in my neighborhood. Anytime you decide to come up here, we could bring a number anywhere in the country, on the road. 4th of July next year, let's do it. We'll plan. Julia, as we sign out, we just want you to know that we wish we could be there for this memorable occasion. We can't believe you're finally 40. You finally caught up to our age. We haven't aged since. We turned 40 many years ago, but I am so glad that you're finally there. Now I finally have a friend that's as old as I am. Happy 40th birthday from all of us here in Provo.
Sharon, you're up.
Oh boy.
Uh-oh, oh no, they're double teaming me. This isn't fair. This is not fair. They can't double team me. Yes. She has thrown me around. She beat me up sometimes.
Kind of the way we work.
I know, they always, they double team me.
Have a seat. Clean up. Be quiet. Now Karen always said the joke was on her. Well, we were sitting here thinking, we thought the joke was on us. Oh no, Julia. We were trying to think, and it made us look. What should we start with? Well, I'll tell the one about the theater, going to the movie with Julia. Yes. We like to go to the movies with her, and
we never see ours.
No. Pocket.
Oh, you guys! I can't believe it! I knew I had
think that she's going a little crazy. She thought it was 0 degrees west.
So anyway, you know, those are just a couple of things.
But I have to say that she's such a good sport. She takes it so well that we just keep coming back.
You just think so.
I hear then she tells Karen.
But I'm not done because okay. I have many specials. Being her neighbor, many I can't reveal. Like a priest. When we walk, so I can't talk about those. But sitting and listening to people reveal how she reveals her body parts, I do have a story to touch on there. But first, we went to Virginia 2 years ago, a year ago. It's been so long. Three of us. We get on the plane. We're so happy to be free of our children and our husbands.
Pouring
and she tells everyone we meet, we have 15 children between us. We have 15 children between us. She had the whole plane looking at us. We got 15 bags of nuts.
I've got one. You've got two.
Oh, my word! And a bottle of champagne. We're all the good at us three. We had a bottle of champagne between us.
You carried faithfully.
We did. We never cracked it open. Not that I could enough. We hid it behind a garbage can, and we left. But that's not as good as the last story. I kind of am the neighborhood picker-upper, and I've picked up Michelle's children if she forgets one. Julia's kind of famous for it. Or if I hear someone sick, you know, I've picked her children up out of the garbage, I mean the gutter, and take them home.
Yes,
but one day I got the call, and Julia had the flu. So I felt I better go down and see what's going on. So I knock at the door, being a good neighbor, and nothing. Knock at the door again, so I decide, well, I better brave it and go in. So I go in, and laying all over the floor, numerous children just laying there ill. So I look over on the sofa bed, is Julia, also laying down. She has no eyebrows. Now, when I walk with her in the morning, I'm a little bleary-eyed. I don't notice that she has no eyebrows, but she doesn't. She's laying there, and she's also about 9 months pregnant with someone in her nightgown. And she sees me, and she sits up to tell me how very ill she is, and her nightgown spreads open, and this large stomach, really white, I've never seen such a white thing in my life, is looking at me. And I keep kind of looking at her, and she just continues because she's so ill, she doesn't realize she's hanging out all over. So I tell her what I'm going to do for her, and you know, lay her back down. I went home and said to my husband, boy, she's ill. It's all hanging out down there. But as I said, I have many, many stories that couldn't be told, but that's just a few weird things. So we wish you a happy birthday, and we did get you this nice basket.
Oh,
with lovely things to help you. There's, as we all know, she's had big gulps, so we got her some Depends. So she can make a walk.
She can climb over as possible.
Oh, that's right. She goes. She can sit and be comfortable.
You don't have to leave anymore. I can sit
there and make comfortable. Everything is there that you need in those Depends. And what else do we have in there?
I see red hair dye.
Red hair dye.
And she's like my color.
Oh, yes. We have heard, look at the mask.
Really?
We have heard there's a few grays.
Yeah, we've seen a few grays. And there's this sudden change. It's neck and throat firming cream. You know, fiddling with your neck. So you put this on, and it's a miracle.
It's a promise.
And you'll see her like this.
Oh, yes. In pictures, we always talk about putting our chins out, you know, so the double chin doesn't show, and we straighten ourselves out here. So that will help you. You can share it with us.
Hot flashes, cold flashes, chocolate flashes. There's a little chocolate bar in there.
Well, that was happy birthday.
Started combing it out. Do you remember?
Mm-hmm.
piece about as big as a 50-cent piece or a quarter came off flat at the scalp.
Oh, yes.
Completely gone.
What that had been here. Her hair. But fortunately, it was here.
And it covered up her hair.
But when it grew in, though, it was straight up. Oh, it just flattened down. I wore it like this to get through that. I pulled it back and put the bread right there. Otherwise,
imagine how mother felt. Oh boy, that's bad. Just trying to please. Okay. I remember she had taken art class in high school. I don't think they taught art. Did they, or music? I remember she coming home from school saying one day there was a girl in her class whose sister was in the hospital with a bullet in her. I mean, the only people who took music at Branham High, were those who couldn't take any other class, I guess. For her, they put everyone who could. It changed. Mr. Neff joined the faculty and it changed. But you missed out on that. I know she loves nice things, and one day she was looking through Vogue or Harper's Bazaar, one of the high fashion magazines, and saw this gorgeous vest, a pheasant vest. And she showed it to her dad, and he says, oh, I've got pheasant feathers prettier than that. Well, and so, maybe you'll help me put this on. She and her dad sat down.
Think the 70s here. This was unbelievably an exquisite piece in the 70s. Yeah.
But, wow. My husband shot the pheasant, and they together made this. And she wore lots and lots.
Had a high neck black hair.
It was gorgeous on her. I remember seeing her in Bliss once. I mean, utter bliss. We were eating in the Russian tea room. I mean, this was, well, maybe not utter bliss. But it was. I remember we were eating dinner at the Russian tea house, and we had ordered this gorgeous food, and it came and it was delivered so beautifully. If any of you have been there, you know how beautiful this place is. It's all red, brass, and deep dark green, and the food was just gorgeous. And she looked at this, and we saw a vegetable we didn't recognize, and we came to find out it was red and yellow and green peppers, julienne style, on the plate. And she decided to drink them. Well, I wonder if this is good. Who ever heard of peppers as a vegetable? She cooked them. Perfect. I thought something had happened to her. I thought there was something wrong with her. But it was just pure bliss. It was so good. So delicious. We love that. Two, I found that in going shopping with Julia, I'm a self-centered person. When I go shopping, I'm looking for a dress that fits me, or something I like, or something I can put in the living room. You go shopping with her, and she's like, oh, Patty would love that. Oh, I could give this to John for Christmas. Oh, I find it hard to buy something for her because she's always, everything she looks at is for someone else would like this. I'll get this for Karen. I'll get this. This is just the way she shops. I kid you not. And so I did today. I bought something. I have heard that she ate a pound of these chocolates in one day.
Yay!
Chocolates in this box than there are people in this room, but I'm going to give the box to Julia because I know that she has all of your best interests at heart. And one day or one evening, whichever. Did you learn that from me?
I'm on that diet.
That's it.
Is this your turn?
I'll back there.
Now, I want to give her one chance to respond.
It's done. It's over with.
Julia loves to have birthday cards. The kids have to make her birthday cards. I mean, that makes a birthday. And she's, from the very time when we first married, was made known to me that I should always make sure there are birthday cards. So, I didn't mean to skip anybody. Gary, you wanted to add something? We'll listen to Gary. Did anybody else?
I
Did I forget? Well, you respond, and I have made a birthday card.
He makes good cards. He really does.
Like the invitation.
Huh?
Like the invitation. Like the invitation. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Go ahead, Gary.
I do need to see it.
I just want to make a quick observation or two from what's gone tonight, as you'll see. Julia's very much a favorite in our home, as you've already heard. And I've learned some things tonight. Now, I've always been in awe of both Rick and Julia because, you know, I can't draw anything. And artistic kinds of things. I mean, my mother likes my paintings, and that's about it. There's stories behind that, but they can do almost anything that way. But I realized something tonight when Rick started. You notice he started out, and I want his kids to hear this, because this is the difference if you've grown up in my home. In your folks' home, Rick observed that your mother has now lived, you know, been married more than she has been single, right, in her life. And he also observed that he hasn't reached that point yet. He's lived longer than he's been married. The difference. He was single longer than he's been married. In my home, it would have been presented to you differently. See, and that's the difference between an artist and where I come. It would have been, your mother has now been married longer than she was single. Your father has also been married to your mother longer than she was single. But your father hasn't been single longer, or he has been married as long as he's been single. Now you have to figure out why. Okay? You get the logic of that down. That's the difference, see, in the family. Now the other thing that hit me was, and I did want to comment on this, Julia came into our family mainly through associations in the music with Greg. And Greg very much enjoyed her. Of course, we have these artistic kids, and they like to sing and do things with Julia. Then Julia and Karen got together, and Karen's always felt and made the statement they met in the pre-existence, you know. She loves Julia. And they've become great friends. See, what I hadn't realized until tonight is that Julia has been a mother figure to Greg.
What?
I just want to throw that out.
We're over 40.
So, anyway. Julia brings the babies over to the house. And Karen has become known affectionately. Guess what, Karen?
Emily knows.
Yes. What is she?
The Goomy Lady.
Goomy Bear Lady.
The Goomy Bear Lady.
Goomy Bears.
And those kids come over. And they've done other things like bring in art and so forth. And I just realized tonight that I'm the brunt of some of those jokes, too.
No, Gary, never.
You're kidding.
But what surprised me is that Karen felt that she was surprised at knowing this for her. Okay. And I just wanted to point that out. Now that's artistic parents. See, we love your mom and dad. You kids know that. We've watched you kids grow and we love you kids. You're a great family. And your mother has meant a lot to my kids. And your dad will never know the example that he is, not only to my kids, but to me, and how much I love him. And I wanted to say that.
My birthday card.
You wash away my tears and take